What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. I am back today with a girl talk, but today we are actually going to give y'all our reaction to Heaux Tales. So, if you don't know, Heaux Tales is the new album by Jazmine Sullivan that dropped on Friday, and it is everything. If you ever been a hoe or wanted to be a hoe, she told a story for you, baby. Today I have Deontay here with us and Kia, who has been here before. And we're just gonna, you know, give you our rundown on the Heaux Tales album. So, I guess we'll start with the first song, which is called Bodies.
That's it.
That's all I needed. Because listen, shit real sloppy out here.
Get it together.
We all have those moments.
But you know, with the song Bodies, I feel like, you know, I've never woke up with anybody and been like, right. Where am I at? Who? What nigga I go home with this time? Have you?
No. I haven't. But at one point, I was piling on bodies and bodies and bodies.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. But I knew who I was piling them on with.
Right.
You know, it was planned.
Yeah. Pre-planned.
Yeah. You know, y'all can laugh y'all want to and say you ain't never had a whole phase. But baby.
Yes. I enjoyed mine.
I did too. Honestly.
I don't think I can go back.
I don't think I'm out yet, but still.
But I enjoyed mine. I had a good time.
Do you feel that hoe or the term hoe is still looked at as bad?
With this generation,
I don't think it is now.
Mm-mm. I feel like as a generation, we've kind of accepted it. And I don't think there's such thing as a hoe, honestly. I think it's a part of being grown and embracing your sexuality. Yeah. You know,
I think that's right now, like in the generation that we're in, women have embraced that. And it's mm-hmm. like, I've taken power of my own body and I'm going to do what I want to do with it. So,
do you think body count matters?
No.
I never cared about it.
Me either.
I put it to you like this. I have no problem with you having a body count. Just don't be like saying it with confidence. Yeah, I slept with such and such and I had
no, but see, that's what I'm saying. Like, as a grown up, like, there's no need to even talk about it.
Right. Why are you asking?
It isn't, but
because what's going to change?
Who can't move past it, so they want to know.
Yeah. If any man ever asked me how many people I've slept with, that's none of your business.
Right. A man never asked me that. So I
would really want to know why.
I want to know why it mattered.
I have known people that literally ask. I'd be like, well, I'm saying publicly saying in the conference, yeah, I done slept with 100 or something people.
That's a lot of people.
Yeah. You know, that's a concerning amount of
people. Confident about that? Oh, okay.
At this point, you're probably a sex addict. You need help.
So the next song we're going to go into is Pick Up Your Feelings.
I felt this one.
I felt this one because a lot of times men do things to us. And they expect us to just be like, take it back. Because they're like, well, baby, no, baby, take your feelings. Because I had to take mine.
And don't know about to be.
Please.
I was trying to get you.
Yeah,
you're off the lease.
You wasn't trying to serve.
Give me my keys.
Okay. Don't ask for
Let me see. Okay, because this is probably the part that did it for me. Yeah, you the one who's double dipping. Yeah, you so sloppy. Because niggas is sloppy.
They are. Off the
lease. Grab me my keys. Yeah.
New phone. Who is this? Okay, because listen, at this point, why are you here?
I think that's funny. I really, like, when it first came out, I was like, okay, it's cool. But when I went and listened to it again, I was like, you just did this. Like, you literally just changed your number a few months ago.
Change your number, new phone. Who is this? Brand new, like the whip.
Absolutely.
Main bitch, I ain't average.
Okay.
You know, a lot of girls can say they're not average. And that may be true for you, but something I have learned from one of my older friends is that you can be the baddest bitch in the world, mm-hmm. but you just ain't that bitch for that nigga.
Right.
And it happens. Like, you're not the say-all, be-all for each guy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, your son ain't gonna shine the same for every male you come in contact with. So it's not like, oh, I'm the best he ever had. Because you may not be. And mm-hmm. we gotta accept that, too. Mm-hmm. So that brings me into my next question. Do you feel that this song brought any emotions, any past traumas mm-hmm. from these niggas to you?
It mm-hmm. did for me.
What did it bring?
I was upset. I was like, this bitch is telling my story. Just a little
right?
bit.
So when that's what I said when I heard the whole album. I was like, she out here telling everybody business.
But I feel
for
like
real.
Her, because she knows me.
But I feel like her album was telling, because you know right now she's currently in a relationship. So I'm thinking it's about her previous relationship that she had. So I was like, okay. She's talking about stuff that happened in the past for her, and it's...
But I actually listened to her interview. It's not just her story. She said she sat down with multiple women and basically got their hotels and made an album, which mm-hmm. was very smart. And I think that's why it's so relatable to every woman, wherever you've
been.
Which
is crazy mm-hmm. that so many people can relate, like, you've been in a situation like this or similar to this before. I think that is crazy. Like, we can't all be out here experiencing the same stuff.
So all you niggas is really this trash. That's what it says.
And this is it.
It was more, you know, I recently got cheated on. I won't say recently. It was a year ago. But you really deal with
recent.
A lot of stuff
That's
through that time frame. But when she was singing, I said, Oh, okay.
But it's like, to me, like, I really liked it because it was like, when I realized, fuck you and your feelings.
For real. And how you feel, because it don't
matter.
Yeah,
like, when I realized that, and I'm like, it ain't even about you no more. Like, mm-hmm. I don't even care how you feel no more. And that's when I was like, yeah.
It doesn't matter. Like, the thing is, they feelings don't matter because mine didn't.
Exactly.
When you did what you did.
Exactly that.
And I think people don't realize.
And they ain't mad at this whole time, so.
Like, they ain't mad at this whole time, so don't worry about it now.
It's okay. You keep your feelings to yourself.
Yeah. So the next song is Put It Down. Mm-hmm. And Put It Down, I liked it. It's a cool little bop, but I can't relate.
I can't.
Like, I ain't never tricked on a nigga. I'm so sorry.
But I do like it.
I do too.
He live with his mama, but I treat him like a kid. Every time he come around, he got me acting like a fish. He asking me for money, I can never tell him no.
But yeah, no. You cannot ask me for any money, thank you. Please do not come again.
Money, keys, cars, nothing.
Yeah, I've never been, you know, she says, you know, if he give you that D, go and trick on that nigga. No.
Nah.
No, thank you. Penis has never been that good to me that I would ever want to spend my money or give you anything of mine. You know, now I have been emotionally attached to a person that maybe do dumb things.
That's different. Yeah.
But definitely still not giving my money. There is something wrong if you need my money and we cannot do this.
Okay.
But yeah, I can't say I have ever been so stigmatized that money was coming out of my pockets. But
yeah, it ain't that good.
Some girls do. I know some girls that's out here tricking on these niggas, and hey, more power to you, sugar mama. But that ain't for me.
Sugar mama.
So the next song would be On It, featuring Ari.
So
Lennox.
Soulful.
It's a very soulful song.
I loved it.
It was soulful but sexy as fuck.
Yeah.
You know, it gave like embody of like, nigga, you want this pussy, but why you deserve it again? Mm-hmm. But she wanted to give it to him, but that's how it be. That's how
like
I be.
Like, I want to, but I need to know why.
Okay.
But give me an example.
I'm not even going to play the whole song. I'm really going to play my favorite part of the song, which is Jazmine's part, because she skated the fuck out of her verse.
Cause baby, it's not that easy to please me. I need my attention with different.
That's when you gotta...
Yeah.
See, girl, stop! No, I feel like Jazmine's voice has always been amazing, but I feel like she has really perfected her craft. Like, that's all I can do, this whole album.
Like, yes,
like, oh, that's it. But I think I liked On It because it basically talked about, like, not only why should we give you some pussy, but, like, is it gonna be worth my time?
Right.
Because a lot of times niggas think they out here throwing dick and it be trash.
Garbage.
And I think, like, that's what she like. Why you deserve it? Like, what you gonna do for me? Because so many people have sex for them and not to please both parties.
Exactly.
And I think, you know, as women, women are starting to get into like, no, I ain't trying to just be having sex to please you. Like, let's do this for both people. You know, both people deserve to have, you know,
pleasure.
But yeah, this song was pure poetry. I feel like it gave what it needed to give. It's probably one of my favorite songs, actually, on the album. The next song is Price Tag.
Yeah.
honest in my head. Money, spending bits. Yeah, I'ma take all that can get. That money keep the pussy wet.
Do you feel like money keep your pussy wet?
I've never been that type of person. Like, I'm not driven. Like, I'm driven by making my own money, but not if a man has money. Like, I'm not just like, ooh, let me give you some because
you got some money.
Yeah, yeah. Like.
And that's the thing. Like, I think sometimes men with money think that because they got money, that gives them an advantage.
And no.
And it doesn't, because I got my own too, bro. But I think for me, of course, I want to be spoiled. I want to be treated like a princess. But the thing is, I don't ask for nothing I cannot do for myself.
Right.
So I think that's the difference. Because so many guys be like, oh, she a gold digger, this and that, the third. But it's like, no, baby, what are you bringing to the table I can't give to myself? So that's really where that comes from me. But money definitely doesn't make me wet.
But I'd take a dollar, you know?
You know?
Drive me off a dollar.
You know, impress me and just call me and be like, have you paid your water bill this month?
I have not.
Here you go. You know, different things like that impress me. Texting me good morning does not.
Every day.
I'm so sorry.
Good morning. Every day. Good night. Good morning. Good night.
Not what I'm doing. Not good morning. Honestly, at this point, I don't care about going out to eat. I go out to eat so much. That's nothing impressive to me. Like.
The song is very sad.
The music is sad.
Yeah. You know when you lost one. A good one, you know when you lost one. Go out and fuck different people to cope.
This song really resonated with me because so many times men will lose the so-called good one and want you to wait for them. Like, you fucked me over, but you want me to give you a chance to get it together. And I just feel like it's not fair. But in the song, she talks about, like, she a selfish bitch. Because, like, that is selfish to ask someone that you fucked over to wait till you get your shit together. Like, that's the most selfish thing you could do. But, you know, who am I? Have you ever lost a good one?
No.
I haven't either. I don't think none of them were ever good.
I think I was okay with whoever walked away.
I never felt like I regretted anything.
I was hurt for one, but that's because that person was my what if. And once I realized that what if person was not the right person, then I was like, okay, that person can go.
You know,
You was sad about it because when you actually got it, it wasn't what you thought it was.
No, I feel like that person wasn't giving us an opportunity to work out. And I can't make somebody be something that they don't want to be.
Well,
or do something that they don't want to do. So my what if person became, okay, well, it's time for you to go. Because you showed the true colors. I just, you know, I see those red flags, but you just don't want to see it. Like, I got to let you go. I lost that one person that made me regret. I'm not going to tell you to wait on me because I'm not the type of person.
So was it that you weren't ready or he wasn't ready?
He wasn't ready.
So you didn't lose him.
Mm-mm.
That wasn't a lost one for you.
It wasn't.
When the lost one song is about losing somebody that was good for you.
Right. And you messed it up.
But I was trying to make him a good one for me.
You can't do that.
Oh, you can't do that, baby.
That don't work.
No, you messed it up.
That's not good. Not make somebody love you the way you need to be loved. Either you choose.
I did mess with her on that.
Either you choose to let someone love you the way they do love, or you go somewhere else where you can be loved that is sufficient for you.
Exactly.
And honey, and my slogan for 2021 is, if he wanted to,
he would.
And that's for anybody.
And that's on Mary Had a Little Lane.
I'm so sick of y'all saying that.
You know, those dancing.
Y'all, I really don't think women realize how much power they have.
Kick them out.
Like, we really do hold the power, but we have given it to these men. And that's why I think hotels and whole, what is it called? Your whole stage or whatever the case may be is important to your growth. I really do. Like, because
you learn so much about yourself.
You learn what you want to deal with, what you don't want to deal with. Like, even if you're not a hoe per se, because I don't believe that any of us are just hoes. But what I'm saying is dealing with other men. Like, I ain't been in no consistent relationship with these men, but I have dealt with men at different times and I've learned different things from each of them. Mm-hmm. And I think that's why now I'm at a stage where
you know what you want and you know
what I know what I want and with. I just don't feel like putting up with nothing else.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So the other side is a song about a girl who is moving to Atlanta to change her life. So we're gonna get into that.
I like this song.
I do too. Love and not a favorite. I'm a voodoo Atlanta. I'm a family rapper. You gon' buy me a booty. Maybe star in a movie. I'ma keep on my business. I'ma star me a business. And I'll never be broke again, struggling. God is my witness.
Hold on, when she said she gonna have two kids by
surrogate, baby, she ain't playing.
Cause you're not gonna mess her body up.
Yeah, I feel it. I like this song. I can't relate per se. Like, I bought my own booty. But I think so many girls, I think this song portrays like the view of so many girls seeing Instagram mm-hmm. models mm-hmm. and like they got with a rapper and then their life turned into this. You know, I think it's the misconception because they don't talk about the ugly side of it. All you see is the glitz and glam from the internet. It's really relatable to so many girls. Because I've even known girls, it's just like, you got to get a nigga with a bag.
Yeah.
If you get a nigga with a bag, then you do this, this, and this. Instead, you know, and I think the misconception is that, you know, it's peaches and cream, but it's not. And I've learned in life that there is a cost to everything. Mm. Like, whether you think it is or not, there is a cost. So, if that's your thing, I'm not disrespecting you, no shade to you, but, you know, baby girl.
But I think it stems from even before Instagram, and I'm saying this because I had a cousin who told me this is what she was going to do. We were like, I don't know, 10, 11. She was going to move to Atlanta. Mm-hmm. She was going to find her a rapper, and she was going to do all this stuff. She's going to be a trophy wife. She was going to write a book about it. Mm-hmm. Like, this is...
But you know, some women do desire to be just a kept woman.
Mm-hmm. I just can't.
No.
I'm not finna depend on you.
I've seen so many kept women turn into broke girls
right.
because they man left them for the next one or they fell out and he ain't taking care of you no more. You don't have anything. So, you know, as my mama tells me, baby, you always keep you a safety net.
Okay.
So, my thing is, although I do desire to be a spoiled girlfriend, well-taken-care-of girlfriend, absolutely.
But it's got to be genuine.
Yeah, genuine, because you want to give it to me. But also, I'm not going to stop working. I'm not going to stop doing me, because I'm building my own. Mm-hmm. And I want to have my own. You know what I'm saying? Like, I personally, if I was being the one, I want to add, too. Like, I want to be able to bring my own stuff to the table. Like, mm-hmm. you know? So.
But I would still be okay if a millionaire wanted.
Absolutely.
I would still be okay. Where's my millionaire? I'm with her on that though. I'm tired.
Yeah, and you know,
like a 6 month vacation.
I'm tired of working. Like,
okay. No, I definitely. Now, don't get me wrong. Now, I definitely want a man who got some coin. But I got my own too. Is what I'm saying.
Right.
I'm just saying, like, my life and my career is not gonna be based off of what somebody else did for me. It's gonna all be off of what I did for myself.
Amen.
But yeah, that's all I really have to say about that song. But I do feel like it's relatable. It makes a lot of girls shallow. Mm-hmm. Because I feel like a lot of girls think that they have to have the longest weave and the biggest ass and the smallest waist to get a certain type of man. And that's not the case. You know, I think there's nothing wrong with plastic surgery. There's nothing wrong with changing your body, but you want to make sure you're doing it for the right reasons.
And then, like, not even being funny, like, these men out here who like certain women on Instagram, they ain't even the type of women that they have at home.
Yeah.
Like,
and honestly, a lot of guys don't even like it. Like, they, like, a lot of guys more so want a natural girl.
Right.
You know? So, you know, going out there and getting ass after ass, because I've been in the surgery groups, and these women have surgery several times to get these huge asses, and it's just like, who are you doing it for? You know what I'm saying?
At this point.
Yeah, mm-hmm. But you do have to make sure what you're doing is for you and because that's what you want to do for yourself, not for anybody else. I Like Me. It's the last song on the album, and I feel like this song
will make you cry on a bad day. I made a profile on Tinder. Said you let me be with her. I think that means I'm getting desperate. Wish I could return to sender, but you don't love me no more. That's
the part that got me.
Yeah.
Is that you don't even love me no more, and I don't know what for. because so often when a man leaves you for someone else or cheats on you, you often feel like it was something you did. And you know it wasn't nothing you did. It just makes you feel like, you know, like, damn, like, I don't know what I did for you to just leave me like this. I feel like that a lot in 2020. Like, I couldn't understand it. You beat yourself up trying to figure it out.
And then you, like, when I, child, because I was cheating on too, Lord Jesus. Not last year, but, you know, whatever. Anyway, I felt like I lost myself trying to figure out what I did. And so for a long time I didn't even realize it. Like, I was this completely different person. I was like, who the fuck are you at this point?
Then
I think that's when I was finally like, pick up your feelings, because I'm done.
Yeah, because
I think that's
you
where I got
brought me to such a low point,
right?
Of how I view myself, because it's like, well, maybe I shouldn't argue so much, or
right,
maybe I shouldn't have done this, or. And then you do start looking at yourself, like, well, maybe he won't, like, you know, like.
And then you start changing these things because you feel like in your mind, even though he's never said any of this to you, you're changing these things in your mind, so you're starting to do it, and then you're going to look up 3 years later and be like, what the fuck?
Right.
Me.
And this part. The same thing.
Something different, still don't know what I was missing. What you asked, I would have given. It ain't right, he's always been winning.
I just, this song just really did.
Don't go for a girl like me.
You know, because girls like us, if we being honest,
we be single all the time.
As fuck.
I've accepted it.
No, but, you know, and then you do look at some people like, damn, they in all these relationships back to back to back.
I know. I be so confused.
Like, y'all done had 10 boyfriends this year, and I ain't got one.
I be so much confusion.
But you know what? I do realize that me as a person, like, my vibe and everything, it don't connect with everybody. Like, I don't connect with everybody, even females. Like, it really takes something. And I'm also an instant connection person. Like, if we don't connect in the first 10, 20 minutes, it's not ever going to be there. And that's just how I am. So I definitely don't meet a man that I can really rock with. But I feel like every 3-4 years.
Oh, damn.
So it looks like I got about 2 more left before I find another one.
I think we're not going to say that.
But anyway, you know, I feel like that's how it resonated with me. I feel like, as a healing girl going through a breakup from being cheated on, I feel like Girl Like Me was a song that I would have really benefited from at the time, because that was literally everything I felt like from beginning to end. Like, what is it? Like, what? It was more so like, what does she got that I don't? You know, like, what made you go over there?
Well, the bitch, let me
we ain't gonna talk about the bitch. We just gonna keep on going.
Yeah, okay.
What did the song make you feel, Deontay?
Well, I never had a serious relationship. I always had situationships which just didn't make it no better. So when they left. Yes, I did my questioning. Like, what made that person better than me? But, I mean, self-reflection, self-worth, self-awareness.
Definitely. Self-reflection is big. What about you? How'd it make you feel?
Oh, what's
sad? It just make you feel sad because you have, it's like, if you've been a girl, even if you haven't ever been cheated on, sometimes the girl, I will say, that didn't get picked, you know,
yeah.
I'm definitely not a pick me girl, but I'm just saying, like, you've been the girl that you've been dating someone or talking to someone, and then all of a sudden they're with somebody else, and it's just like, damn.
And that too, like, as even like a young adult, a teenager, whatever, I always felt like that, like, what's wrong with me? You know, like, you in my face, but I've never gotten.
But you
gonna choose
gave
these
me.
Other exactly.
Yeah,
but you want to be in my face, but you're not picking me, and I feel like I got that a lot.
But you know what? That whole being in my face and not picking me has brought me to, like, who I am now. Like,
right.
You can't be in my face. Like, if you aren't fucking with me on the level I feel that you should, bye.
Yeah.
Like, I can't. Like, I don't know. I don't know if it comes with age. It comes with maturity. But it's just, like, if you're not giving out the same energy that I'm giving out, then at this point, I'm drained. And I've just learned you can't pour from an empty glass. And I'm not going to go into my next relationship drained because I've been pouring into you.
Yeah.
Just so you can stick around. Like, at this point, I have learned that there is happiness and peace and singleness. Thank you, Lord.
And I like peace.
I like peace too.
Mm-hmm. I think too, like, I at this point, like, I say what it is that I'm looking for, what I want, and then if that's not what you're giving, then I move accordingly.
Yes.
Like, I'm not saying I'll stop talking to you, but you're definitely friend now.
Yeah, like, you friend zoned like a mother.
Yeah.
Like, it's definitely not the same energy for sure.
I really shut people out. I just, like, block. We ain't got to go through all this.
I mean, and that's fine, too, because you're not getting nothing out of it.
Oh, you're not. God. It's not worth
but
it.
But I like to talk to people. And I, you know, I live by myself with my dog. And I'm tired of talking to my dog. So...
You
know,
you talk to the people.
I talk to the people.
I mean,
I talk to people in a certain way.
It depends on how we feel out. I'd be like, you know, yeah, we're not gonna keep doing this.
Now, if it was on some
for real,
I don't like how you did me type thing. Like, nah, I ain't talking to you no more. But
I have no problem social distancing from anybody. I'll let you
chop it up a little bit.
Chop it up, talk a little bit.
Talk.
Yeah, I think I definitely entertain more niggas than I do like really fool with them.
Yeah,
just if I'm bored, then I will entertain you. Unfortunately, it's not good on my end to entertain people, but y'all don't want nothing, so it don't matter.
Nothing at all. We've been texting for 6 months. I never.
You don't want.
I
nothing.
Ain't even seen you in 6 months.
You don't want that.
Like,
but you know that brings me to my next point of the song where she says,
"But you gon' make a hoe out of me."
Like, honestly, this is when I felt that, because it's like, I wanted to be in this situation with you, mm-hmm. but now you can put me in the streets.
Back to the streets!
Back to the streets we go.
I can't.
So now I'm back here hoeing. And when I say hoeing, I ain't meaning fucking everything to come by me. I'm just saying, like, now I'm out here intermingling with everybody.
You making yourself available.
Yeah, and yeah. It's just like, I don't even want to be here.
Like,
but you making me be here.
But you know what? It's cool.
But it's not.
But no, for real, it is. It definitely is annoying, because it's just like, I'm really out here in these streets because the person that I was in the house with decided to go to somebody else's house.
He wanted to visit.
He visited, didn't come back. So, you know. Anyway, y'all, that's our take on the album. My last question to y'all would be, what is your top three songs?
Mine's is, what is it? Put Your Feelings.
Pick Up Your Feelings.
Pick Up Your Feelings. The last song with her and Ari.
Those are mine too.
Yeah.
Pick Up Your Feelings.
I like Pick Up Your Feelings, but I don't want to feel like that no more. I'm done thinking about him. So, Bodies. I really like Bodies, and I don't know if it's the way that she delivered it, like how she came in.
Gotta it was definitely
stop getting fucked up. Like,
that is the
I
delivery.
Like how she came in.
Because
on that.
I tell you, me and this girl been drunk all 2020. And high.
It's fine. They have.
It's probably going to carry on.
It is.
But that's just how we're coping with our feelings.
Yeah.
I
think I felt that one. So, Bodies is one. Definitely like On It. And then Girl Like Me, because I feel so much. Like, when I hear that song. Like,
I can relate to
yeah.
it in so many
And
ways.
It's really in a good way for me, because I'm not there
anymore. Yeah.
So mm-hmm. I think that's why I like it, because I can appreciate my growth and how I grew from it.
Yes.
So.
I think this album really does show growth of women in so many different ways, because it's just like living in your truth. And just like niggas, you know, we always just like, well, men can have sex without women. Yeah, they can. But they go through their own thing. They may not ever talk about it, but as a woman, we are more vulnerable and more emotional mm-hmm. creatures.
Mm-hmm. I don't think they whole phase is as tough as ours.
No, yeah. Mm-hmm. I definitely think they can just drop draws and keep it pushing. But for me, like, no. Nah. Well, I've done that too.
It's a different time of your life.
So, at this point in my life, you know, yeah. I'm a little heartless these days. But, you know, it is what it is. I'm going to just tell y'all, do what y'all want to do. It's your body.
And that's okay.
Live your life. And honestly, the key to being a hoe in these streets is don't tell nobody.
Privacy. I was just gonna say that.
Privacy, mind your business.
You got to shut up.
Yeah, definitely.
I think that's why I like the situation that I was in, because, you know, when I tell people, like, I had a whole face, they'd be like, no, you did not. Yes, I did. Never know. Exactly. I didn't tell nobody. The men that I was, you know, they didn't tell nobody, and that's fine. Like, I never thought that I was secret, but yeah, we moving accordingly. This nobody business but ours, so.
Mm. And honestly, after we stop this situation, you don't ever gotta talk to me again. Honestly, you don't even have to know me no more.
But they do, and I be running.
Yeah.
Girl, I be
running. Like, y'all always come back, but that's another story, because I be like, baby, I missed you 3 years ago.
I don't even know you. No, I don't even remember. I remember.
Don't remember.
Okay. But how you doing?
How you doing, babe? How you doing? We're not gonna go back there. But yes, guys, that is our take on Jazmine Sullivan's Heaux Tales album. Drop in the comments your Heaux Tales. If
your
you have
favorite song.
Yeah, your favorite song. Yeah. If you have any questions, I can walk you through this whole shit. Don't say it like that.
I can't.
You never had a Heaux Tales?
Yeah.
You sure have.
Plenty.
So I'm confused.
Because I don't look like the type of person that I have a Heaux Tales.
What does that Heaux look like?
I don't know, but I'm just saying, like, I don't feel like guys think that I look like the type of person that would have a Heaux Tales, so they wouldn't.
But you know what? Let's break down what a Heaux Tales is.
You do that. You don't let like no man put you in a Heaux Tales. You do your Heaux Tales.
Right, but what I'm saying is I don't look like the typical person. Right. I don't look like the typical person who will, you know, will have a Heaux Tales. So I didn't think nothing of it. But you know, I have definitely been through my Heaux Tales more than once.
I think a lot of girls have, they just don't want to admit it.
It is what it is.
It is what it is. I was young, I was single, exactly. Sometimes I wasn't, and it is what it is.
And sex actually has a lot of emotion to it, and yeah, if you don't even know how to deal with your emotions, that's what you're going to. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's what I was going to.
Yeah, because sometimes you thought making up was sex.
Like, right.
This is going to make it better. Like,
it didn't.
And it don't. It's for the moment.
You know, and I didn't even realize until well after my Heaux Tales that I was like, sex in a Heaux Tales is completely different than sex with somebody that you actually connected with. Because,
absolutely,
like you said, it is in that moment.
Because
so once that
so
sex
much,
is done, that's it.
It's it. It's empty sex.
Yeah.
It's empty sex. I have no attachment to you.
It's really
pointless.
Although
I do believe in soul ties.
That is
but I do
true.
Have guys that I have dealt with for the time being, and I don't feel nothing for them.
Yeah.
Like, sorry.
Like, it is what it is.
It is what it is. And then, you know, I have guys that I've had rendezvous with that I caught feelings for, and then, you know, that was that, and I had to deal with it. But I definitely think having sex with someone you love
is completely different
than having sex with somebody that you're just having sex with. The difference when it's somebody you really love and that you really put time in with,
yeah,
and mm-hmm, when that is broken, that soul tie, it's like a different type of hurt.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's that's like you gotta really hurt. Heal yourself.
That
you
heart
know?
Hurt. I feel it.
Yeah, I be feeling it. It be hurting.
That heart hurt.
But yeah, guys, that's
honest.
All the
okay.
That's all the time we have for today. Girl Talk Tuesdays are back. Yay. As long as I got girls to talk to.
Mm-hmm.
So drop in the comments.
Mind your business and drink your
mind
water.
Mind your business, drink your water, and protect yourself out here, ladies. Wear a condom. Get birth control. You know, do what you need to do. Take care of you. Get tested. It's January. Everybody should be getting tested. It's a new year. Tested, wellness checkups, all that good stuff. And we out.